So I'll do pretty much the same thing as yesterday, just continue through the different meditation topics we've covered. Yeah, I don't know. Are there any questions at the outset?
So I have a question.
Okay.
Someone was wondering about if we'd be doing the dissolution in the morning because they're not here right now and they wanted to join during the dissolution.
Yes, we will be.
Okay. I will message them.
Okay. Probably not this hour, but the next hour.
Okay.
We'll get to it. It's coming up fast. Okay.
Thank you.
Sure. And let's get just sit quietly for a minute or two, and then we'll generate a positive motivation and read the four immeasurable thoughts, and then if we like, go for refuge. So first, let's just sit quietly for a couple minutes, try to focus our attention, get comfortable in the meditation posture. And let's visualize ourselves as being surrounded by all such beings, beginning with our mother of this life to our immediate left, and all our female family and friends to our left and behind us, our father of this life on our right, and all our male family and friends to our right and behind us, and those who are most prone to be negatively biased towards, become angry with directly. Imagine them seated directly in front of us, facing towards us, and then all the other sentient beings. Of all the six realms, imagine a human form seated all around us as vast as space. And I still remember our equanimity, equality with them, and that we're all the same and wishing to be free from suffering. And same in having suffering and wishing to be free from it. And the same in having the potential for happiness and well-being up to full enlightenment and wishing to have happiness. And then generate a positive motivation, then specifically relating it to this this session on or these meditation sessions on impermanence and death, or death and rebirth. So why are we here doing this? Generate a long-term motivation, reason for thinking about one's long-term aspirations, and also thinking beyond oneself, including the welfare of others. To help generate these virtuous attitudes of love and loving kindness and compassion and so forth, we can read through the immeasurable, the four immeasurable thoughts one time. How wonderful it would be for all sentient beings to abide in equanimity, free from attachment to friends and anger towards enemies. May they abide in equanimity. I myself will cause them to abide in equanimity. Please grant me blessings to be able to do this. How wonderful it would be for all sentient beings to have happiness and the causes of happiness. May they have happiness and its causes. I myself will cause them to have these. Please grant me blessings to be able to do this. How wonderful it would be for all sentient beings to be free from suffering and the causes of suffering. May they be free from suffering and its causes. I myself will cause them to be free from these. Please grant me blessings to be able to do this. How wonderful it would be for all sentient beings to never be separated from the happiness which is totally beyond suffering. May they never be separated from this. I myself will cause them to be never separated from this. Please grant me blessings to be able to do this. And then if you like, you can visualize an object of refuge in the space in front of you. Shakyamuni Buddha, or one of your own teachers, or anything else that you turn to for refuge. Even an ideal. And then if you like, you can join in the reciting the refuge and bodhicitta prayer. I take refuge until I'm enlightened in the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Supreme Assembly, by my two collections of listening to the Dharma, or we can say meditating on the Dharma. May I become a Buddha to benefit all transmigratory beings. I take refuge until I am enlightened in the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Supreme Assembly, by my two collections from meditating on the Dharma. May I become a Buddha to benefit all transmigratory beings. I take refuge until I am enlightened in the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Supreme Assembly, by my two collections of listening, of meditating on the Dharma. May I become a Buddha to benefit transmigratory beings. So that's the preliminaries. I think today, like yesterday, we'll do about 15 minutes just on placement meditation, practicing generating sort of single-pointed concentration. So again, remember to clearly define your object of meditation, whether it's your breath or the clear knowing nature of your mind or impermanence or something else, loving kindness or compassion. But pick an object just to single-pointedly focus your attention on without analyzing, practicing placement meditation for 15 minutes. So make your clear determination to try to do that as best you can. And then as you're focusing on the object, then remember to use the two mental factors of mindfulness and introspection as I reviewed yesterday. And then also be aware of the two obstacles to be abandoned, which are excitement, which through the force of attachment to things starts, thinking, we start thinking about other things than what we're intended to focus on, or lethargy through a lack of enthusiasm or lack of energy, then the mind sinks down. So be aware to, beware to avoid those and try to maintain the best possible mental focus that you can for 15 minutes. Relax your attention there. And we'll take a 3-minute break.